Wake me up before you go, go. Don't leave me hanging on like a yo-yo. Wake me up before you go, go.
Good morning, Peachtree Ridge, and welcome back to RVN in the Morning. I'm Navia.
And I'm Bree. Here's what's happening around the ridge and the world on Friday, March 29th.
Spring break is finally here. Oh my God, I never knew this day would come. Like, actually, you guys, I'm so happy. Remember, stay safe this break and don't do anything that could potentially harm you in the future, aka anything illegal. April 1st, aka Monday, is the last day to purchase prom tickets, so please don't forget. You're going to regret it if you remember on April 12th that you don't have a prom ticket. So, also remember that April 9th is that wonderful opportunity for future educators to go to a seminar and get some connections. More information is on our video from this past Monday, I think. Boys soccer beat Duluth last night with a score of 1-0, making them 5-0 in region.
Let's go.
Oh, my Lord. Baseball has a game today at Ridge versus Berkmar again, so maybe they'll 21-0 them again. So I guess show up. And last but not least, girls lacrosse has a game today versus North Gwinnett at Ridge, so show up.
Sorry.
Eat them Bulldogs.
Yeah. Here's our Women's History Month fun fact. RVN is carried by women and Evan. Punk Stefani.
Who?
Phil. The groundhog, famous for predicting an early spring, has become a parent along with his wife, Phyllis, according to the Punk Stefani's.
I don't think
Gwen Stefani.
Gwen Stefani.
Groundhog Club. The club announced the birth of two healthy baby groundhogs, but did not close their gender and names. Because we can't put our babies on the internet.
No, man.
Everyone knows the goat Phil did not see his shadow and decided to have mercy on us, and spring started early!
I think the babies should be named Bria Navia in honor of us.
I agree.
Anyways, it's Friday, so let's hit Rapid Fire Entertainment. Last night, Beyonce released her new album, Cowboy Carter, with features like Dolly Parton and Miley Cyrus. Euphoria Season 3 might never come because they keep rejecting the director's ideas.
Please.
Good for them. Please, no more. And last but not least, someone decided to leak SZA's new album, Lana, again. Who's surprised? Her albums always get leaked.
Not me.
Her password might be I heart SZA 123.
I was thinking, okay, I don't even know. Not me. For lunch today, there will be wings, chicken nuggets, and pizza. There's wings on Friday?
Apparently.
Whoa.
It's like
so it's a reward.
I guess Fridays are their
fun little treat. The weather for today will be a high of 70 and a low of 39.
That's all the news we have for you today, Ridge. I'm Navia.
And I'm Breen.
Have a spring break Friday and go Lions!
Solar eclipses. This interesting phenomenon is caused by the path of our moon intersecting in front of the large microwave in the sky known as our sun. A solar eclipse involves the total or partial covering of the sun. There are actually a couple different types of solar eclipses, so let's go over them. A total solar eclipse covers the entire area of the sun, leaving a small glow around the moon. An annular solar eclipse, this is when the moon is just smaller than the sun, leaving a small ring of fire around the moon. Partial solar eclipse is pretty self-explanatory. Instead of covering the entire area of the sun, it only covers a small portion of the sun. Luckily for us, on April 8th, partial solar eclipse will be passing over us from 1:45 to 4:21 p.m. The best viewing experience at 3:05 with 82% coverage of the sun. Now you may be asking yourself, hey, how do we actually view the solar eclipse? That's a good question. Eclipse viewing glasses will be provided on April 8th by the school. To properly view the eclipse, put on the glasses and look at the sun. Do not look directly at the sun, since apparently staring directly into the 5,772 Kelvin burning ball of fire is not a good idea. Hey, I can't see anything in these. Good. Eclipse viewing glasses are specially designed for viewing eclipses, and are dark for a reason, blocking dangerous light rays from turning your eyes into a barbecue. Please do not use sunglasses or any other glasses. I cannot stress this enough. I know one person's going to do it, but please, for my sake, do not stare at the sun. Anyways, that is all we have for now. Make sure to view safely and have fun.